Hello everyone, this video is an instruction manual talking you through the assignment that's been set online step by step. You can pause this video anytime, rewind at any time if you get stuck, and it will help guide you through this task. What is this task? We are remaking Billie Eilish's Bad Guy. Don't worry if you don't have any instruments at home, we're only going to use our mouse and computer keyboards so everybody can access this as long as you have internet access. So I want you to follow me through all of these steps and let's get this task done. So the first thing I want everybody to do is open up Google Chrome as their internet browser. It has to be Google Chrome. The logo looks like this, not Safari, not Internet Explorer, has to be Google Chrome. If you don't have it, you can download it for free online. Just search download Google Chrome. Once you're on Google Chrome, it may ask you to sign in. If it does, you can just use your school email address and your school password. So now that we're in Google Chrome, we're going to search for this website. It's EDU Bandlab. So it looks just like that, EDU Bandlab, and it will be the top link that comes up. So I want you to click on that top link and it will take you to a page that looks like this. So on this page, you need to click start as a student if this is your first time, and it may ask you for a code which will be given to you by your teacher online on Google Classroom or by email. If you have done this before, you can just click log in. So once you're on this sign-in page, use your school email address, make sure it's at tqacademy.co.uk and not at gmail.com, and then it should take you through to the next page, or you can click on this Google icon, but it will still ask you for your email and password. So on your next screen, you want to click join class, and once again, it will ask you for a code if this is your first time. If not, you will already see your classes here. As you can see, I have year 7 and year 8. So once you're in your class, you need to click on the big green start assignment button, and then click Teacher's Assignment once and wait for it to open. And your screen will look like this. The first thing you need to click on is Instruments, which is this square on the left-hand side, and it will create you one track up here. So now we're in our Mix Editor window and we're ready to start making our song. First things first, I want us to change this up here. It says 120 BPM. This is our tempo, which is the speed of the music. So how do we know how fast the song is though? How do we know what to put in here? We could try and work out the BPM ourselves, but that might take too long. So the other way we can do it, and it's not cheating, we can just Google it. So I went onto Google, Googled Billie Eilish tempo, and I found this little gem here, which actually is a full breakdown of the whole song. You might need to do a little bit of reading, but three paragraphs down, and you can see right there, it says 135 BPM, which is our tempo. So we're going to change this to 135. You can either click and drag up, or you can type it in this box, like so. So now our project is the right speed. So now we need to work out what instrument we're going to need first. So we're going to have a quick listen to some of the song, not all of it, just a small clip so we can work out what we need. Have a listen. And that's all we need to listen to really. So to start off with, how many instruments do we need? I can hear two, which is a kick drum and a bass guitar. So we're going to start off with one of those. So to change this track here, we're going to change this track to kick drum. Now at the moment, it makes a piano sound. So we need to click on this picture up here, which looks like a little piano, and it will bring up this menu here. If you click on this top one, you can change what the instrument is. So we need a drum kit, and then on this second one, you can click on this menu and it will change the drum kit sound. Now you can listen to these by hitting these play buttons. So this drum kit sounds like this. And this drum kit sounds like this. And so on. So you can have a play with all of these and you can pick whichever one that you think sounds best. For now, I'm going to go with Chill Wave. So now that I've picked my sound, I need to be able to put it into this track up here at the top. And to do that, you just double click on this grey area and you should have some sort of box appear. And we're going to drag that to the front of our timeline, the very start of our song, bar one. So we've got four bars of music ready to put in now. One, two, three, four bars. So on our bottom half of the screen, this is where we're going to click our notes into. You can see up here, again, it shows us what bar we're on. So bar one, bar 2, bar 3, bar 4, and it even shows each beat. So this is beat 2 of bar 1, beat 3 of bar 1, beat 4 of bar 1, and then we go on to bar 2, because there's 4 beats in one bar. You can use these magnifying glasses to zoom in and zoom out when you need to. In this little window, you can see our drums on the left-hand side. It's got little pictures, and you can click on them to hear what they sound like. Now, none of these are a kick drum, so we're going to need to scroll down in this window. To do that, make sure your mouse is in this area, and then you can scroll down and have a look at what else there is. And our kick drum is the one right at the bottom. So this first part is actually nice and easy. To get your note into this window, all you need to do is double-click on one of these squares. So on this line is the kick drum. I've double-clicked and my note has appeared. We need to click one of these on every beat in these four bars, just like this. So you can see beat 1, beat 2, beat 3, beat 4, and if I play that by hitting the space bar, you can hear that it sounds in time. Now you could click them all in, or you could copy and paste, which we are going to use quite a bit, so we might as well learn how to do that from this point. So to copy and paste these notes that we've just put in, you need to click and drag your mouse in this window, like so, and you'll have a grey box appear. Drag that grey box over your green notes to highlight them. Now that they're highlighted, you can use Ctrl-C if you're on a Windows computer, or Command-C if you're on a Mac, and that will copy. And then before we paste, you need to make sure this white line is on the correct beat. In this case, we need to move the white line to this 3, and you can do that by clicking just underneath it on this red bit here. So now that our white line is on beat 3, we can now paste it by using either Ctrl-V on a Windows or Command-V on a Mac. And then we've copied and pasted what we just did, and it should, as long as that white line was in the right place, now all be in time and you've filled out the rest of your bar. Now that we've completed 4 bars, we can loop that further by clicking on this red square up here. You'll see this little icon in the top right corner. When you move your mouse over it, it will change to an arrow. If you click and drag that circle, it will loop what you've done as many times as you want to. For now, we're going to move it all the way up to just before the number 9. So 8 bars of music on the number 9 line. We're now ready to add our second instrument in. Can you remember what it was? Let's have another quick listen. It was the bass guitar. So to add a new track, we need to click this button up here in the top left, add track. And then once again, we're going to click instruments on the left-hand side. Now that we've got our new track, we can rename our instrument just like before so that we remember what we're doing. And we can change our instrument by clicking the picture of the piano. This menu will come up once again. Click on the top one and it will bring this menu up. Bass is all the way at the top. Again, you can use this second menu to pick a sound that you like and hit the play button to hear them. I'm going to use dub bass for now. And just like before, we're going to double click in our track area for our box to appear so we can put our notes in. And we're going to click and drag and move it to the start of the song once again. Now our bass line is an 8 bar loop. So we're going to click and drag this bottom right circle. When we move our mouse over it, it will change to a little double arrow, and we're going to drag that all the way up to the number 9, just like before. So now we've got 8 bars ready to put in. So at the bottom half of your screen, you should see a little window like this with a piano on the side and loads of grey lines in the middle, just like the drum beats before. If it doesn't look like this, double click the blue box and this will appear. If your notes on the left-hand side are greyed out, it might mean that you're scrolled too far up, as a bass guitar can't play these notes. So you may just need to scroll down so that you're in between C1 and C3. You should be able to use all of these notes. Now don't worry, I'm not going to make you go and learn the bass line before we do this part. You should see in the bottom right corner of your screens some menu boxes. Now you've got one that I don't have that says assignment brief. Now in that assignment brief, I have already put the notes, just like this. So we've got our notes in a box on the right hand side. This is how we're going to make our bass line. You can also see that there's a piano on the left-hand side. This is just like a normal piano, and all the C notes are labelled. So you should be able to work out what note you need next by counting up the alphabet going from C to C. So for example, this first note is C, the next white note is D, the next white note is E, then F, the next white note is G, the next white note is A, then B, and then we're back to C. And it goes like that all the way up. So all the C's are labelled. You can also see in this window light grey and dark grey lines. The light grey ones are white notes and the dark grey ones are black notes. The first note we need is a G. If you don't know where G is straight away, you can work it out by counting your way up. C, D, E, F, G. So this is our first note right here. We're going to double click, just like with the drums, and our note will appear. The second note is another G, and we're going to click that in two boxes away from that first one. So one blank space, two blank space, and that's where our next note goes. You can see the next note we need, it says B, B, but one B is capital letter and one B is lowercase. When there's a lowercase B next to a capital letter, that means that we flatten the note down one. So in this case, we're going to find our B, which is just below C, and we're going to flatten it down one note, which is this black note here. So that is a B flat. Our next note is a G, which we already know is here. And we're going to do these all in a row, so no spaces in between. We've then got three more G's, but we're going to leave one space in between each. So one there, and one there. We have another B flat. We know where that is because we've put one here straight away, no space. Another G, no space. And then we need an F, which is the letter before G, so it will be the white note below this one, which is here, with no space. If you now put your playhead back to the beginning by pressing enter on your keyboard, you can then hit space to hear what you've made so far, which is the first part of our bass line. I'm just going to make one small change to this, and you can copy this as well. If you hover over the edge of one of these green boxes, you can see your mouse changes, and that will make the notes longer or shorter. I'm going to make this first note two boxes long, and I'm going to make this last note two boxes long, so you can do the same. The next part of the bass line is exactly the same. It says we need to do this twice. So just as before, nice and easy, we're going to copy and paste. Click and drag in this area to get that grey box, highlight all of the notes you've just done, hold Control C or Command C to copy, and then before you paste, we need to make sure we're in the right spot up here. In this case, it's going to be on the number 3 again. So click just on the blue bit underneath the number 3, make sure your white line is directly on time, and then you can hit Control V or Command V, and then it will paste what you've just done. So now we've got two out of four sections of our bass line done. The third one, I'm going to show you a little trick. We're going to paste our first section one more time. Make sure your bar is on the number 5, and then you can paste again. So now we've got three. I want you to make sure that you've highlighted your third section, which is between bar 5 and bar 7, like so. And we're then going to click and drag all of these notes upwards. And you can do that by clicking any of the green boxes in the middle and holding down, and then you can move them. In this case, we're going to move it up, this first note, up from G to C. A, B, C. Now, all of these notes are in the right spot, they're in the correct rhythm, apart from this last note. So then you can just click this last note and move it up to a G. B, C, D, E, F, G. So now we've got one bit of our bass line left. This should be nice and easy, as we've done it a few times now already. The first note we need is a D, and the D is always in between the two black notes. So you can either work it out from over here, or you can see that we've got groups of two black lines and groups of three. In between the two is always a D note. You can see this note is two blocks long, which is fine. We're then going to leave one space, and then we need another D note. So we're just going to shorten this one to one block long. We then need an F note straight after, D, E, F. and then another D note straight after, so that it looks like this. For the last part of the bass line, it says to use 3 Ds, but it says lower D. So you can see down here, I've got another D that I can use, and I'm going to leave a space in between each one. Now, depending on which sound you used, you might not be able to use this lower D, in which case, you can just use the one that you was using before up here. And that's your bassline part finished. So if you press enter to move your playhead to the start, you can then play and listen to what you've made. This is actually a good place to stop for lesson one, so don't forget to hit save using the grey button in the top right hand side. Do not hit the green submit button, as we've got more to do next lesson. So just keep watching the video for lesson two. I'm just going to get rid of this menu here so that we can see this side of the screen. I'm then going to use these magnifying glasses to zoom out a couple of times, just so I can see a bit more of the project. I want to be able to see the number 33, because I'm going to click on our red box of the drums, and then use our loop button in the top right hand side of it. You can see here where the mouse changes to an arrow, and we're going to loop it all the way to the number 33, just before the number 33, right there. And we're going to do the same with our bass line using the top right hand side. We're going to click and drag this top right circle all the way over to number 33. Okay, so now we're ready to add our third track. So let's have a quick listen to the song to see what instrument comes in next, other than the vocals.
Think you're so criminal. Bruises on
there it is. So you can hear there a snap of the fingers came in.
Needs for you, don't say thank you.
One, two, three, four. One, two, two, four. One, two, three, four. And they're landing on every beat two and beat four. So that's what we're going to put in next. So we're going to add another track by clicking this button here again. We're going to use instruments again on the left hand side. And then we've got our third track. We're going to click on the piano picture again, and then we've got this menu, and then we're going to click drum kit again, and then you can use the second menu to pick your sound. I'm going to go for chill wave again. So then to get our box up, we need to double click on the track area. I'm going to double click around number 9, and it's put it in the right place. So we want to start from bar 9 this time. So you can see here on the bottom half, I've made sure I'm in the right spot. You can see 9, 9.2, 9.3, 9.4. But we also need to use the right drum. The snare drum is once again at the bottom of this menu. You can see it right here. I'm going to use this one, which is this light grey line here. Now we worked out already that the snare drum lands on beats 2 and 4 only, which means we're going to click on this line on beat 2 and beat 4 for the rest of this square. 9.2, 9.4, 10.2, 10.4, 11.2, 11.4, 12.2, 12.4. That is our third part done. Nice and easy. We can now loop it using the top right hand circle and drag it all the way to the end. Now we're ready for our fourth track. Let's have another quick listen to the song to find out what's next.
So you're a tough guy, like you're really rough guy, just can't get enough guy.
Can you hear it?
So you're a tough guy, like you're really rough guy, just can't get enough guy, just always a puff guy.
So it's another drum. So we're going to go back to our window. We're going to add a fourth track. We're going to use instruments again. Click the piano again. Change the top one to a drum kit again. And then pick a sound that you like. I'm going to go for something different this time. Let's try funk kit. So this time we're going to use the hi-hat, which is this one here. I'm just going to rename these tracks so that I don't forget which bit's which. This was the snare drum, and this is going to be the hi-hat. So now that we've picked our kit, we're going to double click in this area again, this time from bar 17. And you can see here that it started in the right place. If for some reason it starts a little bit early, you can see here at the top it's out of time because the pink bit is before the 17. Just click and drag and make sure that that is in the right spot. So I've got a nice little trick to get this hi-hat in time. This is going to be nice and simple, just like the snare drum. We're going to click our hi-hat in, which is this cymbal here, B Be careful because it looks very similar to this one. But you can see it's just above the drum. It's this black line. And we're going to click our hi-hat, double click, on every beat all the way along to 20.4. I'm then going to zoom out with one click on this magnifying glass. So now that I've zoomed out, I can see all of my notes. You can have a quick listen if you want. But we've got one more change to make. So what I want you to do is highlight all of these notes. So click and drag from somewhere in this area, cover them all with the gray box and let go. And then you're gonna move them by clicking in the middle of one of the green boxes, one square, just like that. And now if you have a listen, that's much better. That's exactly what we wanted. And that is our fourth part done. So once again, we're gonna loop it all the way to the end. So we're now on our final stage for this Billie Eilish song. We've got one more part to add. And if you haven't guessed already, this is that final part.
I'm the bad guy. Duh.
So let's go back to our window. We're gonna add our fifth and final track by clicking add track. We're gonna use instruments again. I want you to click on the piano picture again. Bring up your instrument menu. And then this time we're gonna pick synth leads, which is near the bottom. Now in here, again, you can pick whichever sound you want, but there's actually a sound that's called eyelash synth. And if you play it, it sounds really similar to the actual song. So that's the one I'm gonna be using. So we're gonna double click on our track to get the box to appear. And this time we want to start from bar 25. So we're gonna move this box to bar 25, but we also want this to be 8 bars long. So we're gonna click and drag our bottom right circle, wait till the mouse changes to the double arrows, and then drag this to the end. Now we're ready to put our final riff into this song. You might still be zoomed out like I am. In that case, just click the plus, and then you can zoom in and maybe see a little bit clearer. You want to be in between C4 and C5 for this riff, and you can bring up your assignment brief so that you can see the notes we need. They are all here. So the first note we need is gonna be a G. So again, go from C, D, E, F, G. It's this note right here. And you can double click that in. That's our starting point. You can see that lines up with the G note. The next note we need is going to be a D, and we're going to go up to that. So we can just use C5, and the note above it is going to be a D. And there's going to be no space, so we're going to do it straight after this first note. Our third note is another G, but we're gonna leave a space in between this D note. So we're gonna leave this one blank and then put our G in. We then have a D followed by a lowercase b. Can we remember what that means? It means that we flatten the D note. So instead of putting in this normal D note, we're gonna move it down one space. And then we have a normal one straight after, and then another D flat straight after that, and then a B flat, which is just two notes down. One, two, and then there's our B flat. If you have a quick listen to that one bar of music. So now we've got the first part of our riff. Now you can continue clicking these in, but we need to do this 4 times in total. So we need 3 more of these, and the easiest thing to do, just like before, is to copy and paste what we've already done. So click and drag in this window, highlight all the notes that you've done, and then hold Control C or Command C to copy. Make sure your white line is on the 26. And then you can hit Control V or Command V to paste. You can then do it again on 27 and again on 28. And we've now got 4 of them in a row. I then want you to do a fifth one on 29. And then this time, just like before, we're gonna click and drag to highlight our bar 29 notes. So make sure you're on the 29. Highlight all of these notes. There should be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And then we're gonna click and drag in the middle of this green box and move them up from G to a C. These should now all be in the right spot. This is a C, this is a G, this is another C, G flat, G, G flat, and E flat. And it says that we need to do this twice. So once again, you can highlight these notes. You can now hold Control C or Command C to copy. Make sure your line is on the number 30 and then hit Control V or Command V to paste it one more time. We're nearly there. We've got one more line to do and then you've finished this project. We should be on bar 31. We've got six more notes to put in. So the first note we need to use is a D, which is always in between the two black notes, remember? So right here. Our next note is an A, which might be difficult to spot, but remember you can just count your way upwards using the white notes. So if this is a D, the next white note is an E, then an F, then a G, and then it starts again on the A, which is there. We're then going to leave one space and put another D. We're then going to put in a G flat, which we've used over here, so we know that this is here, with no space. We've then got another D with no space. And then we're going to click our final note in, which is a C, just below the D, which will be here, but we're going to leave one space, like so. And that finishes our final track. So you can hit enter to move your playhead to the beginning and listen to your full song from this point. It should be about a minute long, so have a listen to what you've made. You can even copy and paste all of these sections at the same time. If you click and drag in this area, like so, you can move your grey box to cover all of your tracks. Once they're all highlighted, you can hold Control C or Command C to copy. Make sure your white line is on the number 33. You also need to make sure that you've clicked on this top track, because we're going to paste all of these. You can then hit Control V or Command V, and you've pasted the whole thing. And now you've got 2 minutes of a song. Don't forget to hit the grey save button. You can also now click the green submit button so that your teacher can listen to your work.